Hey, where do we leave off? Here. This might be too loud. Alright, so I was just last time I worked on this code, I was trying to do type sizes and alignment. So particularly, you know, a struct, if it has let me just give an example. So in Ion code, let's say we had a vec2, has, and I don't know, well, this is, I called it vec2, that's stupid for what I'm gonna do, but alright, if it's this, right, then if this is a 4-byte int, right, then the alignment is 4, because that's the largest type in this struct. But if, say, this is an end pointer, now this is 8 bytes, right, and so there's gonna be 4 bytes padding here, right? So I'm trying to work on that. So the reason I decided to like try out 10x is because, so I'm a hardcore like Vim user, but I just recently cut my finger pretty bad, and you know, you use your index finger a lot for Vim, and I haven't been able to code very well for the past week or so. So I decided to try out, you know, a non modal editor, just why I'm fucked up. So and 10x has been really good for this, particularly because it has a lot of like cool mouse features. Like, I typically hate using mouse, like I'd rather just be on the keyboard all the time, but with my finger fucked up, it's I could still use the mouse like with my middle finger, you know. And 10x has some cool like code exploration stuff with the mouse, like, you know, if I hover over like some function and middle mouse click, you jump to that definition, and then like the side buttons on the mouse are back and forward, so like I can jump back to where I was. You know, let's say I like went around a bunch, I don't know, like scrolled up here, checked out this thing, and then this thing here. Then you could just keep backing up to where you were, or go forward. It's pretty cool. So yeah, I'm actually liking it a lot. I mean, I could probably fuck with a lot of things, but whatever. Okay, so let's see, where were we? So, what to work on next? So, let me see. I haven't been really maintaining a to-do very well. I mean, type inference is kind of, yeah, that's what led to all this. So before that, I was working on this case where it's, what is this? Oh yeah, that was for alignment. I hate fucking using the mouse so much. Okay, so this case, right, where you have a, you know, specified type in the var declaration, but then in the expression that, you know, you assign to the variable, you can have an inferred type, and not just the, like, the outer type, but in this case, you know, you have a two-dimensional array of some struct, and so the struct, you know, initializer is, type is inferred, and then the, you know, vec2 array is inferred type, you know, both of these, and then the entire, like, array of two vex is also implicit. So that's cool. So we're kind of working on type inference. I guess we just did this one. So what can we do next? I mean, we're working on this overall. This is just part of the whole analysis pass. Yeah. I mean, this is just describing the passes of the, or the phases rather, of the compiler. I guess there's more shit to do for type inference, right? Let's just figure out some more. Well, I guess, okay, another thing is type size and alignment. And I think I'm more interested in type inference at the moment, so let's see what we can do there. So, you know, the var declaration is a case where we can have an inferred type. I guess function arguments can also be a place where we have inferred. But I think functions in general are sort of lacking. Yeah, I mean, our expression resolution is also quite lacking. We're only just starting resolution, really. So, what do we have? Expression resolution. There's a lot of work to be done with functions. Yeah, and like tracking source position, tracking source code position. I guess like line and column. Am tired. Maybe let's look at, you know, type inference and function parameters. What does that look like? Let's take these guys. Alright, so we have a function. What is this song? This is hot. Atom Smasher. Sorry, I hope it's not too loud. Right, so but this is not a function. It's gonna be in a call. The call is where you have the right. So when you call, and that only happens in function bodies, which we're not. I don't think we're even touching function bodies yet. Alright, so let's not tackle that. What other cases do we have? Type inference. Okay, there's also like the case that something like I guess this is also in the function body where you have something like some variable of some type declared, say it's a vec3. Really, typing without an index finger is so fucked. And then later you say just x is equal to some thing, right? Compound literal. This should work because you should be able to infer the type from this here. But this only works in a function body. You know? So we gotta deal with that. What are we even doing with function bodies? Suppose we can find out, right? How do we do this? Let's use some bullshit. Concatenating string literals to do this. Actually, what will that do in an array? Suppose if we just put a comma before the last one, it'll still work. So, let's see. You open the scope. Before we do that, let's save these. Alright. So, what are we gonna do in here? Let's just say, like, I mean, we're just trying to see what the function does, right? So we just do what I just did. You got 666. Return result. No comma here. Uh, Actually, it should be here. So this is one string. And then, you know, this shows order independence because the vec3 isn't defined until here. Let's see what's going on. I have to, like, finger type this shit out. Like, search and pick, what do they call that? I forget. Alright, what's in resolve? So, we just want to see what it's doing for this guy. So, you know, I suppose we can look in resolve decal func. Ah, shit, I'm getting a call. Hold on. Alright, sorry. Had a call, but alright, we're back. So what I need to do is actually have something for resolving functions. So resolve decal func doesn't exist yet, so let's do that. It's going to take a declaration. Right, we're going to make sure it's a func. So, what do we need to do for functions, right? Well, you have basically a list of parameters and a return type. And a name, right? We can look at decal. Whoa, what happened? Func, right? You have parameters, return type, and a block. I really didn't have this. Ah, you did, but you never called it. I see. Okay, well, ultimately, you're going to return a function type, and we do have that, so oh, this song is sick. Sorry, I'm going to crank this. That part is so sick. Alright. Params. Params. And a return type. Alright. So, we need to resolve all of the. It's basically the same as like a compound literal. Right, we're gonna do something like this. Normally, I wouldn't work this way, but like typing is so hard with this without this finger, so I have to do all this mouse stuff. It feels so awkward. All right, something kind of like this, right? So you're gonna have like basically we need to translate this into like a type, right? So for a type func, what you doing? Look at him. What's he doing? You making a bid? Nice. Oh shit. All right. That works. So gotta do. We need to go through all of the decal func what the fuck are they called in here? Params here, yeah. Decal func ramps. So let's see. Num per ramps. Is this? God, I feel like I'm at like 30% efficiency typing with this thing. It's so annoying. Alright, so we're gonna go through all the parameters and then we're gonna need to. Resolve all the types of the parameters, so param type, resolve type spec of, god damn it, decal. It's like, so I have to keep these three fingers like shifted up one key normally, and then like when I have to use the other half, like for semicolons and like arrows and shit, I have to shift them back. It's so awkward. All right, decal func params. This parameter. Right, so we're going to resolve that type. I mean, what we could do. Wait a second. Something I just thought of. I don't really need this hanging around anymore. I don't know if I want to go look at this right now, but one of the things I just thought of is, like, in this case, right, for a function, I'm going to, like, you have to pass every parameter, like, an argument for every parameter of the function. But for struct initialization, like a compound literal, you don't have to do that. Like, you can have, if there's, say, three fields in the struct, you can only initialize one, and then the others get initialized to zero. But my question is when I implemented that resolution, like, I think I just assumed that you would fill out every item, or rather, like, the items that you did, you would initialize. What I'm getting at is, like, I may have only allocated enough memory for the number of fields that you explicitly initialize, and I feel like you need to allocate memory for all of them. Compound or resolve decal. I don't know, where is it? Compound. Expert, yeah. Okay, so what do we do? If it's. Okay, we go through expert compound number of arguments. Wait, what? This is not what I'm thinking of. I'm thinking of the alignment thing. Here. Right, it's in the type completion for a struct. So the number of fields is the aggregate number of fields in the declaration. That makes sense. Then you go through all of those and you resolve the type. Right, this is a stretchy buffer that we're just appending to. And then here we're getting the alignment. Actually, yeah. Well, here we're getting the alignment. Here we're getting any padding for the struct. But yeah, sorry. So that is not what I expected. It's not in the actual parsing of the thing. You don't resolve up front. Wait a second. Yeah, so in this pass, when you resolve, all you're doing is resolving whatever arguments you gave for the initialization. So I'm getting a little lost here. What I'm confused about is, like, where, you know, once we resolve the expressions that are the arguments to a compound literal, we're not, like, storing those anywhere. Right, and what spurred me to think about this is like, okay, whatever arguments are not explicitly passed are going to be zero initialized, and we need to like do that somewhere. So, you know, you return this resolved thing, which is just like, all right, the type is struct. But it's not complete yet, and then, you know, when you go do the completion is when you start allocating memory and stuff. Num fields comes from the declaration. I mean, you're only dealing with types at this point, not like the actual values of the types. Right, so like we're not using the values of the arguments, but it is still important to resolve the expression because you know, you could reference a type that you haven't seen yet. So you need to discover those dependencies. Alright. So, you know, I'm trying to wrap my head around what the fuck a compiler is, and this is that process. So, we'll go back to resolving Vognsen. Alright, so for all the parameters, we're going to get the types. So we need to resolve all the types. We need to resolve the return type, red type, right, red type, chances of barking in his sleep. So cute. Okay. So let's look at this type func, right? The type fields are the params, so we need to create these type fields. So let's make a stretchy buffer of params. That reminds me, Never mind. That's a different thing. The difference between type completion and the instantiation of types introduces some differences, but I digress. So stretchy buffer of params. So we're gonna push onto params a new type field. The name is the decal name, or sorry. Probably want this. These guys are func params. Func param. It's this. Doesn't really matter, but I kinda like that. Wish I had long hair. What is this? What are you sending me? You're distracting me. Alright, well, it's downloading, whatever. So, we're gonna gather all of these. We're gonna gather all these parameters. And then pass it in here. So, type func needs to do the memdupe, right? Memdupe it does. Nice. Damn. This is good shit. What am I doing for the body? Well, I mean, the body's not part of the type, is it? Well, I guess Nah, it's part of the declaration. Bonk has a sub block, right? And the symbol has both the type and the declaration. Right. Alright, so in resolving the type, I suppose we do actually need to descend into the statement body in order to discover dependencies of the function, right? So you can order it. Because when you do this, you put it in ordered symbols, don't you? No, you cache it, but you don't. So, who calls this guy? You. And then you would put it in the symbol table. All right, we resolve the return type. Let's just, you know, check what's going on right now. Function body. Oh yeah, we're still running it in remedy. So what do we got? Incompatible types. From type spec. Oh yeah, this is supposed to be resolve type spec. Thank you, compiler. And then int differs in level of indirection from, yeah. Makes sense. So now, let's see what happens. Here. So, let's run to here. Wait, halted. Did we for sure build this thing? So we're not even getting to resolve equal func? Really? Alright, well, where are we getting? Program halted. Well, what's happening? What's going on here? This is weird. Syntax error, unexpected token and base expression. Okay, so what's happening here? Like, why is it not? Where's this output? Windows is weird about output, right? Like, you have to use, like, output debug string or something. In Linux, you just fucking print the standard out. It works. Wait, so it's a parse error? It's a syntax error. You're expecting a semicolon and you don't get one. Where? Alright, what are we looking at? So we hit funk, right? It's gonna be keyword funk. Yep. So we parse decal funk. Parse the name. Sure, we get the return type. Oh my god. I wrote it in C syntax, didn't I? Wait, what? Dot bar? Wait, what the fuck is... Where is this period coming from? Oh, it sees a tab. What? Really? I wish I had, like on Linux, I would just go man ASCII and look at this. Look at the man page. So what's the value? 133 decimal, I think. Decimal 133. Horizontal ellipsis? The fuck? What's a tab? Horizontal tab is supposedly this. Alright, well let's just remove all ambiguity. Like, why didn't that work? I don't understand. Still exploding, what the fuck? What's going on here? Oh shit, we're probably not even parsing function bodies, are we? No, we parse the statement block. Is that ellipsis actually there? So it blows up here? We got the token. About to parse this statement. What is it? It's keyword var. I Alright, so it's a simple statement. It's not auto-assign. Increment, decrement, this one. Interesting. So we're not parsing var declarations. Right, because now you're gonna need local scoped symbols. Locally scoped symbols. So essentially it's the same as a global var declaration, except scope's different. Well, would it be retarded to just, as a first step, just make it global? Make all of our declarations global? Like, obviously it is dumb, but like, just to see what the code needs to do, I think it's, I just need to figure out what the code needs to do. So, so we're parsing statement blocks. So is there a difference in a var statement and a var declaration? Like, I'm honestly... sort of confused about... So what happens for the assignment stuff, right? Like, simple statement, I guess. So here you're assuming it starts with a name then in the simple statement case, right? I'm not seeing where the name is coming out. Alright, so right now it's token var, it's keyword. Are we supposed to admit VAR? Is VAR just a global thing? Right, like what if we just said, why can't you just have that? Result, colon, type, equals. Huh. I mean, I'm torn, like, part of my brain is saying, like, alright, you should just call out to parsedecl var when you hit that, but then I'm not quite sure that so I didn't design this language right. Sorry. Per Vognsen created this language, so he's the one that would know, so I guess we should just look is there like some examples, some tests? Instead of a function, right? Are there any? Where's all the var stuff? There we go. Yeah. So var is not used at the function level. It's only for declaring global. Variables. Makes sense. Yeah, so this is what we should do. Just what I was doing. Alright, so the consequence of that is we're still going to descend into this parse parse statement block. Where the fuck are we? Simple. Here, this one. So you're gonna parse simple statement, which is gonna be like, if it's token auto assign, right? So we're gonna have to switch this up. So with statement init, you have a name and an expression. So I think we need to expand the statement, potentially. Because now you need a type spec for... So, inits can have a name, a type spec, and an expression. The type could be null and the expression could be null. So then, let's see. So right, init type spec. Damn, that's pretty wild. All these perfectly line up. It's kind of cool. So save that. This guy. So who calls this? Just you. So if it's token auto assign, I feel like we need to split this whole thing up, right? Something like rather. If you match token colon, which we don't have because we use literals. So if you match the token Alright, so you have to have a colon and then an optional type. How would you know that though? Well, you check for equals, I guess. Alright, so if you hit the colon, if there's an equal, otherwise we parse the type. What do you have? You have a type spec pointer. And you parse the type. feel like we can put this. Whoa. I feel like we can put this here. So we'll start out null. So if it's not equals, then we expect the type, we parse the type. Parse the type. Then we say at this point, if there is an equals, so if it's not equals, then you know you have a type, so we get that. I feel like we should maybe just, it seems like it would probably be easier to just do a first check that's like, alright, if it's colon equals, do the simple old thing. Otherwise, yeah, but you can't really do that, because... Well, I guess you can, yeah. You say if it's colon equals, you do the old thing. Otherwise, if it's a colon, you do that. You've already checked that it's not equals, so you parse the type. And then you can also do a better message. So, what the fuck? I think we just do another else thing. Alright, so if it's token auto assign, we do this. Else, if it's that. No type. This is an inferred type thing, right? So for parsing, yeah, it doesn't matter. That's going to be a resolution thing. So if you match colon, then what do? Well, ultimately you're going to do one of these. So if it's colon, you parse the type. Oh yeah, you can say if match token equals. If it's equals, you parse the right hand side. And the statement is this name, type on right hand side. That makes sense. Suppose you could do the same thing here. Although, honestly, that should be a fatal right now, because... Maybe not. Are there any type of syntax errors we want to check for here? Is there low-hanging fruit? Well, you're saying that you've parsed some expression, which is going to be, it has to be a name in both of these cases. That expert, it's not that, but it is that. It should be a name. We parse the type, which is vec3. Great. We have an equals. We get the right hand side. Great. Suspended. Alright, we just parsed that. So now let's go to here. We're resolving it. What the fuck? Some weird shit is going on. What? Parsing it just fine. It's an auto assign. Well, that's not quite true there. So we're parsing. Yeah, so let's look at the printer. minute knit. Init, I guess. Init name. Print type statement init type. Then the expression. Cool. Init result vec3. What? Very confused now. This init of so init result space type space expression. Vec3. Right, is that because it's a... Yeah. Makes sense. It's fine. Okay, so what are you gonna do now? Alright, so resolve deco funk. We left a nice little to do for ourselves. So you know, you got this Stackelfunk statement block or something like that, right? Right, just block. Which is just a list of statements, right? For the block statements. So, I mean, we could pull that off. Okay, so we go through all the statements, and what do we do with them? Is there like a resolve statement thingy? What the fuck? What the fuck is the editor doing? Are you serious? Don't change my shit. I just want to say resolve. Statement. What the fuck? This is bizarre. Like, the second I type in an open paren, it just auto... Well, now it doesn't? Well, that's great. What the fuck was that? Resolve statement. Yeah, what the fuck is that? Alright, right? The second I do an open paren... It changes my shit? Don't fucking do that! Jesus Christ. Like, why in the world would you ever autocomplete without, like, an explicit, like, attempt to autocomplete it? Alright. I'm not gonna get hung up on it. This is gross. That's a gross line right there. Maybe what we should do is pull out the block then. So we do this. So num statements, block statements. I'm tempted to use the same pattern we did for expressions and do like a resolved statement thing. Something like that. Okay, so the reason we did that for expressions is because it's basically the return value, you know, of a resolve expression. So what type of things does a statement need to return? A resolve statement need to return? Well, you know, the reason it's a statement and not as an expression is because it produces some side effect, so... Well, yeah, a side effect's not necessarily a thing that needs to be stored in a, like, returns. It just happens in the function call. So, I don't know. I'm not sure resolve statement will return anything. So for now, I don't know. We'll start out saying maybe it doesn't. We just resolve the statement. Because, like, what's the point of this, right? We're trying to complete types and find dependencies. I mean, that's a good start, I suppose. Is this like why did this get broken up from here? Honestly, this can go right here. Okay. So, what do we got? We got these types of statements. Oh man, I gotta take Chance out for a walk. Well, let's see, is this a good stopping point? We're about to implement resolve statement. I suppose so. We left off here. Man, I wish in Vim I can just like copy paste so quick, just YY and then P a bunch of times. Just yank it and paste it, but I don't know how to do that here. I can't wait till this finger heals. Alright, I'll be right back. Alright, I'm back. Chance has been walked. He is happy now. Look at him. Say hello. You happy now? Alright. That's good. Okay. We were doing this, so... we're doing statements now. So, what I was thinking is to just... Is this loud? It seems a little loud. You know, maybe just handle statements similarly to how we do expressions, and you know, have this resolve statement function that, when called, will, you know, just switch on the types of statements and dispatch to a corresponding resolution function. Yeah, I mean, it makes sense to me. I mean, basically, what's going on in statements, right? It's basically, you know, different types of expressions in there, or more statements, you know, like a recursive thing. You know, like a while has some condition expression, and then just a statement block, so... I guess there should be some kind of like resolve statement block then that basically does this thing. Yeah, so I guess where do we put statement stuff? I guess before declarations, but after expressions? Doesn't. Okay, so if we have a... Right now I'm just gonna say void, because like an expression produces a value. Unlike C, ion does statements do not, like, evaluate to a value. They just have side effects. Dang, he's like, super clingy right now. He just wants to chill. What's going on with your ear? You got a thing in there. Let me get that. Okay, so let's say we have a resolve statement block, which will take a statement block, which is just a pointer and an integer. So we can do that by value. So you pass in a block, and yeah, so the interesting thing here is statements are going to have a scoped symbol table, right? Need to handle that some way, and like the natural way to handle that is with some kind of stack. So, you know, you're gonna want to be able to like push a new scope, and then, like, I feel like the ideal like way to API, I guess, would be some kind of, you could push a new scope, then just, you know, create symbols and have them go into that scope and then pop at the end. But let's try to get sort of the structure of this down first. So if you're resolving a statement block, you're gonna do what we were doing here. Resolve statement block this, Whoa, what was that? Okay, control scroll changes font size. Oh shit, is the font tiny for you guys? Oh god. Maybe we should go up a little bit. Is that alright? Hopefully that's okay. Not bad. So, yeah. Sure. We resolve a statement block. Alright, so resolve statement, I suppose. I don't really like this font either, but whatever. Switch on statement kind. Oh my god, my hand cramps so much. I'm not used to using these three fingers so much, or in this way. Also, I think, like, protecting this finger, I'm, like, constantly, like, flexing it back because my brain's like trying to protect it or something. Alright. Yeah, so we could have what kind of statements? These kinds. Does this, does 10x have like multi cursor stuff? Like. Oh my god, why is this so slow? Jesus, what is going on? DNS address? What? Oh fuck, we have no internet. How the fuck is Spotify working? That's why it's darked out. What the fuck? Well, fuck it. We don't need internet. We can just... Oh shit, is this... Whatever. Let's just keep working. We don't want to keep working. Focus. Okay, so... Probably don't have multi cursor, or I don't know how to do it. So, what are we gonna do? Well, you could have a return statement. That kind of statement. So you're either just going to be resolving expressions or resolving statements. Right, so... Statement, return, statement, expression. Alright. Great. For continue, you do nothing. Break, you do nothing. Like the do nothing thing should go up front. Statement brace block. Cause there's already like a statement block, right? Is it in the type? Oh, right, it's because, of this, you want this function, this constructs a thing of type statement block, right, yeah. Anyway, alright, statement brace block. It just has a block, right? Resolve statement block. Okay. If we have to do a number of things, right? You have to resolve the statement if statement condition. Resolve the if statement, then block. Else ifs. An else if, what does it have in it? Condition and block. So for each of these, you do this. So we get a pointer to the else ifs, right? Yeah. Elsif Sedai. Condition. Elsif Sedai. Lock. Okay, which means I'm gonna have to wrap this into a new scope. Because we have a variable declaration. Alright, that's all the else ifs, and then there's a else block. If statement. Suppose I could also get a, well, statement if statement, else block, right, never break. Suppose that should be returned, but depends on if anything happens after that. So for the 4, it's gonna be similar. Statement 4. Well, 4s have an init, addition, an x, and a block, so we can call a resolve statement with the init. Suppose those are all optional too, right? I'm sort of torn here on whether I should have, like, should I just call it every time and have resolve statement say, like, if it's null, you just don't do anything, but then, yeah, I suppose we should at least assert that there is one before we start dereferencing it. Or sorry, accessing fields. Yeah. I guess we'll do this. So there's an init, a condition, a next. Init, condition, next. Init. Expert. Next. And then a block. Well, Block resolve statement block. Forward declare. Force area makes sense. For do and while, they're the same, right? Case statement while. Well, we have a statement block to resolve, and we have a expiration. So hard to type statement. While statement condition. While statement block. Switch. What do you have? You have the expression, all the cases, so this we have this box, man, is sick. Sorry if it's too loud. Alright. So for each of these cases, we want to, so switch case, what's in a switch case? It's like its own fucking block. I'm gonna punt on this for now. Cause it's a lot of shit and I'm just trying to get the basic shit going on. Okay, the sign's gonna be important. Init and expression. Well, that's super easy. Case. Just resolve the expression. Statement. It's probably just statement expression, right? Yeah. Okay. Default. We're just gonna assert zero. Yeah. All right. So for statement assign. resolve expression, statement assign left and right. For this one, you gotta name a type and an expression. Statement, init, type. Suppose this is a resolve types back. Init type. We do that. Then we say if there's an expert, we resolve the expert. You know? Eat some food. All right, a huge to do. I guess, yeah, just local scopes. Scoped symbols. Example variables. Function bodies. All right. This is resolving function bodies, which we're kind of working on. Fill out expression resolution. So. Big one. See, I'm still trying to fucking JK back into normal mode. Jesus. Alright, well, can we compile? No. Struct comparison. If statement else block. That's a statement block. Well, we can just call resolve because isn't that a for loop? Yeah, so it just won't do anything. Resolve statement block is happening here. So oh yeah, we've for declared. Cool. So yeah, now we compile. Cool. compound literal is missing a type specification in a context where its type cannot be inferred. Where's that happening? Here, probably? Mm-hmm. Makes sense, because we're not passing the expected type in. So, for assign, probably? Or init. Resolve expert. So yeah, if there's a type, we resolve the type spec, which gives me a type. So we need to do something like this, right? Type. Start with null. There's a type spec here. We can do that. Then here we can say if there's an init expression, we can call expected with this type. Incompatible types. Wait, what? I don't know. There's extra parentheses. Yeah. Okay. So. Unknown symbol result. Return result, which would be this. Which kind of makes sense. Alright, you're gonna call this. It's a name. And unknown symbol. Cause we're not doing, you know, local symbol table shit, so that makes sense. Alright. I think I'm gonna stop for now. I need to get some food and stuff, so yeah, I'm gonna come back and do, I guess, some locally scoped symbol stuff later. Peace.